Hello and welcome everyone to this video on Linear Integrated Circuits Laboratory course. So in this video, I will be giving a brief overview on the list of experiments, the instruments and apparatus used during the experiments, and the fundamentals required in order to perform the experiments. So before proceeding with the experiments, students are requested to abide by lab norms and rules. Students are requested to wear proper uniform, shoes, and carry your ID card. Try to avoid heavy metal watches, bangles, long chains, etc. Kindly abide by COVID safety protocols. Students are requested to wear masks and requested to carry your own sanitizers. Students are requested to be ready with their observation notebooks. Prepare well for the theory part of the corresponding experiment. Kindly fill the intent form to take the required apparatus needed to perform the experiment. So now, let us discuss about the list of experiments. Our lab is basically divided into two sections, the first being digital and second being analog circuits. Under digital circuits, we will be designing a full adder circuit. And the next is to verify the truth table of multiplexer of a 4x1 mux. And under the analog circuits, we will have to study the basic op-amp circuits, that is inverting amplifier and non-inverting amplifier. The next is to design a stable multivibrator using op-amp for a given frequency. Let us now discuss about the fundamentals that are required to perform the experiments under digital circuits. So now, let me give an introduction to the basic components. So first of all, we'll be using ICs, which is the fundamental of any circuit. So the name of the IC will be printed on it. So this IC, the first two letters is 74 and the next two numbers is 08. So this is 7408 IC, and this IC will be used for performing AND gate operation. So we will be placing this IC on breadboard. So this is breadboard, and in a breadboard, the middle two paths, so these all the paths will be shorted, and this path two respectively, and these paths, these two paths are shorted, but these are two separate paths. So these paths are shorted like this. So this is the basic connection of a breadboard. So we will be placing this IC on the breadboard, and while placing this IC on the breadboard, we should make sure that this IC, this small curve, this is placed towards our left, so we generally use it for a reference. So while inserting it on the breadboard, please make sure that you handle the IC with care. You do not press it too hard, because pressing it too hard will damage the pins of the IC, and don't leave it too light too, because else the connection will be very poor. It will not be pinned into the breadboard. So this is a point that needs to be made note of. Let us now discuss about the IC name and the logic functions that each of the IC is designed to perform. So as I said, each of the IC will be named starting with 74. So this will be common for almost all the ICs. And the rest two numbers determines which type or the which logic gate or the logic operation the IC is going to perform. So 7400 will be performing the NAND gate operation, 7402 will be performing the NOR gate operation, 7404 will be performing NOT gate, 7408 will be performing AND gate, 7432 will be performing OR gate, and 7486 will be performing XOR gate, and 74266 will be performing XNOR gate. So here the point to note is that the last two numbers determine the logic operation or the logic gate that each of the IC is designed to perform. Now, let us see how we can implement logic functions using ICs. So this is a 7400 IC. So 7400 means it is used to implement NAND gate. So you can see NAND gates in this IC. So internally, this is used to perform the NAND gate operation. So we have four NAND gates with the single IC. And always the 7th terminal is connected to ground, and the 14th pin is connected to VCC, that is the supply. And supply will be typically 5 volt for the IC which we are going to use in our lab for this 7400 IC. So we'll be using a plus 5 volt supply, DC supply. So as we can see, 4 NAND gates, the inputs will be respectively 1 and 2 for the first NAND gate, and the output will be 3. And for the second NAND gate, the input will be 4 and 5, and the output will be from 6. And for the third NAND gate, the inputs will be respectively from 9th and 10th pin, and the output will be taken out from 8th pin. And for the fourth NAND gate, similarly, the input will be from 12 and 13, and the output will be taken out from the 11th pin. So this is how it works. And always make it a good habit, or try to follow this convention of keeping this mark towards your left, because it will be easy to identify the pin numbers. So in our lab, we will be given this kind of a digital system trainer kit. We will be mounting our IC on this breadboard which is given on this kit. And the first thing that we need to make is we have to connect the ground terminal to the 7th pin and the supply, 5 volt supply that will be typically using, to the 14th pin. So then after doing that, we'll be applying our inputs. And in order to give the inputs, the yellow pins are made available. These yellow pins represent the inputs. We have to connect the inputs to the IC from these pins, and we can change it to logic high or logic low based on the required condition using the switches which is given. And the outputs will be taken from these green pins. The green pins are connected respectively with LEDs, and the LED will glow in case of a high output and will not glow in case of a low output. At last, now let us discuss how we can place and remove the ICs from the breadboard. We should place the ICs gently on the breadboard. We should press them gently. We should not press it too hard, because pressing too hard will damage the pins. Nor we should leave it too light, because leaving it too light will not ensure that the connection is proper and tight. And while removing the IC after the experiment is over, we should not remove it from our bare hands. Instead, we should place a small wire through the gap which is given in the breadboard, and we should pull out gently, and the IC will come out very easily. We should not apply pressure on the IC and then pull it out, because it might damage the pins. So kindly follow this proper practice. So far, we have discussed about the fundamentals of digital circuits and the practices that we need to follow in lab. Let us now discuss about the basic fundamentals and instruments that we'll be using for analog experiments, that is the analog circuits. So in the analog side, we have two experiments, namely inverting and non-inverting amplifier and the design of a stable multivibrator. So, and for both these applications, we will be using this IC741, which is the op-amp IC. And the saturation voltages will be given through pin number 7 and pin number 4, that is the plus VCC and minus VEE supply. And it will be given through a dual power supply. And for this IC, this supply will be plus 12 volt, and here we'll be giving the minus 12 volt through the dual supply. And the inverting and non-inverting inputs are respectively applied through pin number 2 and pin number 3, and the output is taken from pin number 6. So the diagram is represented in the left, the actual IC and the various pins of the IC. The figure in the left represents the dual power supply. So here we have positive and here we have negative. At negative we get minus 12 volts, and at the positive we get plus 12 volts. The negative is to be connected to pin number 4 and the positive is to be connected to pin number 7. So for IC741, the saturation is 12 volt plus or minus 12 volt, and an additional ground terminal is provided, and it is to be used wherever we have the circuit ground, or we wherever need to ground the circuit. The figure in the right represents the input supply, and this IC741 can handle a maximum of 5 volt DC supply, and beyond which the IC can get damaged. And this supply is connected and generally given to pin number 2 and pin number 3 based on the inverting and non-inverting inputs whichever we use in a circuit. While designing the circuit, Students are requested to take the required value of resistors, such as the feedback resistors, input resistors, based on the required values, and they are to be connected on the circuit board, and capacitors of required value to be taken for the design of phase stable multivibrator, and they are required to make the connections as in the circuit diagram, and oscilloscope is to be used wherever we need to check the waveforms, such as in the phase stable multivibrator circuits. And that's all. Thank you so much. Hope you're clear with the fundamentals.